It's a little quiet on the Azure news front this week, maybe because they're preparing for build, but there is a brand new service that is going to help you implement real-time functionality in your solutions, and Microsoft has acquired yet another company, Kinvolk. Let's dive into some news. Hi, I'm Gwyn, and welcome to another episode of Azure This Week. Azure Web PubSub is a new Azure service that enables the use of WebSockets and the PubSub pattern to create real-time interactivity for your solutions. WebSocket is a standardized communication protocol that provides full duplex communication. Full duplex means it's capable of providing two-way communication at the same time. Since this protocol is supported by all major browsers, it's key to building efficient real-time web interactions like livestream chat, multiplayer video games, IoT dashboards, trading, market live data, and more. The service is fully managed and globally available, offering built-in support for large-scale client connections and highly available architectures. This means, as a developer, you get to focus less on infrastructure and more on business logic. Azure Web PubSub service supports native WebSocket and a variety of programming languages, including C#, Python, and Java through WebSocket APIs. Also, fantastic news for all of us Azure Functions fans, the Azure Web PubSub service is natively integrated with Azure Functions and allows us to build serverless applications using WebSockets. So yay for serverless. You can go and get hands-on right now with their free tier, which is designed for dev test environments, and you can create applications with up to 20 connections per unit and 20,000 messages per unit per day. I'll make sure to leave a link in the resources. Azure has a service called Signer R, which is similar to the new Azure Web PubSub service, so I'm eager to see how they'll differentiate the two and if PubSub is the future. Kinvolk is a company that's focused on building and improving open source Linux technologies in the cloud native space. They are the creators of Project Flatcar Container Linux, which is a container optimized OS, and Project Locomotive, which is an open source Kubernetes distribution that ships pure upstream Kubernetes. In a blog post announcing their acquisition, Kinvolk has stated, quote, "Our main goals were to have a significant positive impact on the open source communities we are involved in, and to work on projects and technologies that allowed us to focus on collaboration over competition. We joined Microsoft to further these goals in ways that we could not have done alone," end quote. Quite a touching message. Microsoft has stated that it's, quote, "excited to bring the expertise of the Kinvolk team to Azure. Will be key contributors to the engineering development of Azure Kubernetes Service, AKS, Azure Arc, and the future projects that will expand Azure's hybrid container platform capabilities and increase Microsoft's upstream open source contributions in the Kubernetes and container space," end quote. And before we start to speculate, they have also stated that Microsoft respects and wants to learn from Kinvolk's team, their great track record in starting, building, and nurturing open source community projects, and Microsoft is committed to maintaining and building upon Kinvolk's open source culture, end quote. Overall, I think it's another fantastic move on Microsoft's end in displaying their commitment to the improvement and, of course, the support to the open source community and open source technologies. Great move on Microsoft, and congrats to the Kinvolk team. And that is it for this episode of Azure This Week. Just a reminder, we'll have Brian Rohim doing office hours next Friday, the 14th. I'll make sure to add a link to all the details, dates, and times that you'll need, and, of course, an invite to our Discord. Will you be testing out the new Azure Web PubSub service? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with all cloud news. Keep being awesome, cloud gurus. I will see you in the next one.